Hey everybody, welcome back. This lesson is about spatial resolution in radiographic imaging. Spatial resolution is an important quality factor. It is defined as the structural sharpness recorded in the radiographic image. Each of these images has a different level of spatial resolution. The first image is very blurry. The edges are not sharp at all, which is the same as having low spatial resolution. The second image has less blur or increased spatial resolution, and the last image has the highest spatial resolution. There is no blur, and the edges of anatomic structures are very clear. It's important to produce radiographic images with excellent spatial resolution. In this set of images, there is a fracture of the greater tuberosity, but it is only visible in the image with the highest spatial resolution. And that's why the operator must understand how to produce images with the highest spatial resolution. You can also think of spatial resolution like this. It's the ability of the imaging equipment to demonstrate the difference between two objects that are very close together. In this shoulder image, the bone fragment is separated from the rest of the bone by a very tiny fracture line. Spatial resolution is the ability of the system to clearly demonstrate these small objects and the small spaces. Several terms are sometimes used to describe spatial resolution. An image with high spatial resolution might be described as having high detail, high sharpness, or low blur. It's also important to understand that spatial resolution refers to the detail recorded in the radiograph, not necessarily the detail that's completely visible on the radiograph. For example, this first image was taken with a grid, and the sharpness of structural lines are clearly visible. The second image is actually the same image, but without a grid, so the image has a significant amount of scatter. The structural sharpness still exists in the image, but it's harder to see because of the scatter. These images have the same spatial resolution. Just remember that an image might have very good spatial resolution, even if the sharpness of structural lines are disguised by scatter or poor contrast. It might be easiest to understand the definition of spatial resolution by thinking of one of the most common causes of poor spatial resolution, which is motion. The first image in this series shows very sharp structural lines, so that's high spatial resolution. The sharpness of the structural edges is very visible, so that's high visibility. The second image still has a high level of spatial resolution recorded in the image, but poor contrast has made the structural sharpness difficult to see. The last image shows very blurry structural lines because of motion. That's low spatial resolution because the structural edges are not sharp at all. And of course, if the recorded spatial resolution is poor, then the visibility of structural sharpness is also poor. Here's another way to think of spatial resolution. It's the ability to see very small parts or very small spaces between parts in a radiographic image. In this first image of a magnified hand, the very tiny trabecular markings in the bones are sharp and clearly seen. In the second image, the small trabecular markings in the bones are blurred and not so easy to see. The brightness and contrast are the same, but the spatial resolution is different. Spatial resolution is its own quality factor. It's not the same as contrast, brightness, distortion, or receptor exposure. It's important for X-ray equipment to produce detailed images of small parts. And this is actually tested using a tool called a line pairs device. The tool has several small line pairs placed close together. As the lines converge, they get smaller and closer together. The smallest lines that can be visualized on the image represent the spatial resolution of the image. The upper image has a superior spatial resolution because smaller lines can be distinguished from each other. So, radiographic spatial resolution is described with units of line pairs per millimeter. It's also possible to describe spatial resolution with a measurement called the modulation transfer function, or MTF, but that's outside the scope of this lesson. Here's a quick practice problem so you can test your understanding. Which of these images has the highest spatial resolution? The correct answer is B. This image demonstrates the highest level of sharpness. The other images all have varying levels of blurriness and lack the sharpness of this image. This image does not have the highest contrast, but remember that contrast is a different image quality factor. So what affects radiographic spatial resolution? There are five general categories. We have patient factors, such as patient size and patient movement. Also beam geometry, that's the SID, OID, and the focal spot size. There's also image receptor factors, that's the detector element size, the pitch, and the fill factor. We also have digital image factors, that includes the pixel size and matrix size. And finally, we have digital display factors, that's the monitor used to display the image. Those factors include the pixel size, pixel pitch, and the matrix size. If you enjoyed this video, I encourage you to visit cloverlearning.com and explore our robust selection of video-based courses, certification exam prep question banks, and continuing education resources. Lastly, please remember to hit the like button, subscribe, and turn on notifications so you can stay up to date on our latest videos.